2018 Honda Odyssey Performance and Driving Impressions Review. Agility is a surprising trait in a minivan, but the Odyssey delivers, and its ride isn't compromised as a result. The Odyssey is quick too, but its braking performance is slightly below average. Acceleration, is it a minivan or a hot hatchback? The Odyssey Elite we tested pretty much blew the I'm the parent of an honor student stickers off the rest of the competition. It beat all comers at our test track, zipping from 0 to 60 mph in just 6.6 seconds, with most of its rivals about a second off its pace. Despite its powerful output and speedy test results, the 3.5-liter V6 is usually as polished as they come and as well isolated from the cabin, except at very high engine speeds that most minivan drivers are unlikely to experience, where it gets a bit raucous. Ride, handling, and steering. The Odyssey changes direction crisply, and from behind the wheel it's easy to forget you're piloting a three-row van. The steering is direct and the effort is light, but more feedback from the road would be welcome. Driving enthusiasts won't rave, it's still a minivan, after all, but the Odyssey is the best driving minivan, and its nimbleness makes it competent in corners and easy to drive on narrow roads. Our Elite test van's ride wasn't as compliant as that of our long-term Chrysler Pacifica, but its standard 19-inch wheels could be partly to blame. Our XL test vehicle wore 18-inch wheels and seemed better suited to pockmarked Michigan roads, but the smaller tires compromised cornering grip slightly. Over most road surfaces, the Odyssey displays a comfortable ride, and few passengers will complain. Braking performance is where the Odyssey's dynamic traits fade. Its pedal feels soft when you first push into it. What's more, the Odyssey Elite also suffered from the longest 70 mph to zero stop in this matchup.